This video presents an example for collision detection. We'll check to see if the hotlinked IFC MEP model collides with the architectural model. We can define two groups using element criteria sets and then perform collision detection for the two groups. We will use ARCHICAD's markup functionality to add comments and screenshots to collision entries. Then we'll share these markup entries with the engineers using the BIM collaboration file format, or BCF for short. Engineers can then see all the documented collision entries using applications which support the IFC and BCF file formats. Let's start by hotlinking an MEP model created by the engineers and exported as an IFC file to the ARCHICAD design model. We'll display only the load-bearing elements in the design model, and then display the hotlinked MEP model in this context. We've already created a model view which displays the structural elements only, so let's have a look at its settings. The general panel of the View Settings dialog displays the required layer combination used by our structural view. We use the core-only option for structural display to ensure that only the core of the load-bearing elements will be displayed. We'll continue by hotlinking the IFC file provided by the engineers. Let's display the floor plan view to start the hotlinking process and open the Place Hotlink dialog. Please note that there are dedicated videos presenting the Place Hotlink dialog and about the details of the hotlinking process. Let's add a new hotlink to the design project. We'll be using the IFC NJB MEP IFC file. Please note that ARCHICAD is now able to use IFC files also as hotlinks. The new IFC hotlink is now visible and can be selected from the list. After selecting the master layer and defining other hotlinking options, we can continue and place the hotlink into the design project. We can decide on where to place the library parts received from the IFC hotlink. We recommend using the Embedded Library option to make sure that these elements will always be present in the ARCHICAD project. If the IFC source file contains multiple stories, we can define which story should be associated with the current story of the host project. Now, the external IFC source file has been successfully placed into the host ARCHICAD design project. Let's have a look at the results in 3D. Let's use the structural model view. Switch on the layers of the hotlinked IFC file. Now the 3D view displays not only the core of the load-bearing structural elements, but also the hotlinked MEP elements and systems as well. Let's have a closer look at the MEP elements. Let's continue and check to see if there's any collision between the warm water pipes and the load-bearing interior walls. The Collision Detection dialog displays two panels named Group 1 and Group 2. We can add criteria sets for both groups. Adding multiple criteria will help us filter the model elements and run collision detection only between those elements that we are interested in. Once we've defined the criteria for the groups, we can start collision detection using the check button. In our example, we want to check for collisions between the load-bearing walls and the warm water pipes of the MEP design. We can leave the All Type option for the element type on the Group 1 panel, because it can be about more than one wall element. Let's add classification to the list. Select the Is option, then choose the wall classification from the list. We can leave the All Type option for the element type on the Group 2 panel as well. This is because we want to include only the warm water pipes. We can filter the model by considering only the layer where these elements are located. Let's add layer name to the list. Select the Contains option. We know that the name of the pipes contains the text warm water. so let's enter this. Once everything is ready, we can press the check button to run the collision detection. The collision detection report displays the results. Here you can see the total number of checked elements in both groups that fulfill the specified criteria. The collisions found displays the number of elements which collided. You can also see how many new markup entries we created. Let's continue and see how to use ARCHICAD's markup functionality. The Markup Entries panel displays all the clash entries grouped by stories. We can display any of the clash entries. The elements which collided are displayed in red. Any of the clash elements can be selected and zoomed in on as well with a single click. ARCHICAD's collision detection is a great tool to get feedback on the engineering work in terms of the actual stage of the architectural design development. The markup palette provides handy functions to communicate the collision entries which were found. We can inform the engineers that they need to modify their design based on the results of the collision detection. The capture option can be used to create a screenshot of the clash entries discovered during the collision detection process. The attached view is not merely a screenshot, it includes camera position and 3D cutting planes as well. These types of captures are listed in the attached view. Additional text notes, using the Add Comment option, can also be added to provide a further explanation of the clash. Clash entries may be exported and then shared with the engineers using the Import and Export Markup Entries option. The exported BCF file can be sent to the engineers. The content of these file types can be displayed by those applications which support the IFC and BCF file formats. BCF files store issues and messages assigned to the IFC model elements. Let's see how our markup issue can be displayed in software which supports BCF. Let's use the Tekla BIM Site IFC Model Viewer. First, we need to load the two IFC models that provide the collision detection in the project. The IFC models are needed to show the elements assigned to the BCF issue with their IFC Global Unique ID. Therefore, both the architectural and the MEP models are loaded in one BIM site project. Let's open the BCF issue as a note by clicking Sharing and then Import Notes. Under Notes, we can find our markup entry stored in the BCF file format. It shows the name of the entry, Clash001, the author's name, and the text message, "Please solve the collision," and the image. By double-clicking on the image, BIM Site sets the same model view as if it was set at the ARCHICAD markup's definition. They do this by rotating the view to the exported camera position, and by adding clipping planes with their position stored in the BCF file. Clicking on Objects selects the pipe and wall objects assigned to the markup entry. Of course, ARCHICAD can also import and handle BCF files received from another application. Let's see an example. Here, in Tekla BIM Site, the CAD manager created a note for adding a suspended ceiling. The message reads, "The suspended ceiling's height is wrong. Please correct it." In ARCHICAD, BCF files can be imported with markup tools. By opening the BCF file, a new markup entry is created. The markup entry has the same ceiling name as the name of the note in BIM Site. Clicking on Apply View adjusts the 3D projection settings to the BCF's camera position, defines clipping planes, and selects the ceiling assigned to the entry. ARCHICAD's collision detection enables designers to perform clash detection between two groups of carefully filtered element sets. The model filtering is performed based on element criteria sets.